Hi, I'm Colin, and today we're going to cover and demonstrate the three components that make permeable pavers permeable. The common misconception is that you may believe that the paver itself can permeate water through it. Well, that's partially true, as all concrete pavers can absorb a little bit of water. There are really three components that help assist a paver system to make it permeable. Those three components are an open graded base construction system underneath the paver that has water flow at a rapid rate. Then the paver itself will typically have a 1/4 inch or 3/8 wide joint. They can do this with spacer bars or manually spacing those paving stones. And then the joint material will be a clean washed open aggregate like 1/4-10 or HPB that also helps permeate water. Technically, to be a permeable paver system on paper, you need to be able to infiltrate 100 inches of rainfall per hour per square foot of your project. The most crucial aspect when it comes to the base construction in a permeable paver application is that everything is comprised of crushed and clean open aggregates to have as much void space as possible to accommodate extra infiltration. Our base material is going to be at least 30% more in a permeable paver system than a dense graded paver system or a standard paver system to accommodate that infiltration. Then we're going to have a clean crushed open bedding material on top of that. The base material needs to be at least 30 or 40% more than a standard paver application to accommodate all that extra water. Let me show you how it works. So the second component that's going to contribute to a permeable paver system is going to be the paver itself. Now the standard paver has about a 1/16 inch or 1.5 mm size spacer bar just to accommodate a fine joint sand, whether dry sand or polymeric sand. Whereas a permeable paver technically is going to have a 1/4 inch or a 3 inch wide spacer bar. So when you put them together, it creates this significantly wider joint, and you can sweep in a larger material like a 1/4 inch material or something like that that's open graded. That way it can withstand that infiltration to contribute to the system. So the third and last but not least important component to making a permeable paver actually permeable is going to be the joint material. Even if you built this entire paving stone project with an open graded base construction and a paving stone with a wider joint, you will still jeopardize that permeability if you used a standard paver joint sand or a polymeric sand, as it doesn't have enough infiltration to be considered a permeable paver system. So you need to make sure you use something 1/4 inch to 3/8 crushed and open gravel to allow for lots of infiltration to contribute to that permeable system. So last thing to add into our demo box here is we're going to be sweeping in 1/4-10, which is a crushed 1/4 inch open gravel that we have a good supply of here in our area and makes for a good joint material in a permeable paver project. So with all three components in our demo box here, we have our 6 inches of compacted 3/4 inch open aggregate base, which is the specified amount for a pedestrian application of permeable pavers, our bedding material, then our paving stones with our 3/8 inch wide joint, and then our last thing, which is that joint material being an open graded crushed stone. We're gonna be taking our watering can and dumping it onto our pavement surface here, and you'll be able to see that water infiltrate and come out of the bottom of this demo box in real time. So we hope this demonstration of the three components that actually make permeable pavers permeable have helped you navigate through a permeable paver project. If you want to learn more, make sure you watch our video, How to Install Permeable Pavers.